Hello, welcome to Standard Deviation and Coefficient of Variation. This is topic number 3.7, which is a part of Unit 3, Measures of Dispersion and Skewness. Today I'll be discussing about how to calculate standard deviation for a discrete series, for an ungrouped frequency distribution, and for a grouped frequency distribution. Let's just see the first one, which is an ungrouped frequency distribution. What do you mean by ungrouped frequency distribution? Where the values of x are in discrete values, there is no grouping or there is no interval given, like class interval 0 to 10, 10 to 20, not given. For each and individual discrete values, like suppose the value of x is 4, there is a frequency is 9. Similarly, the value of x is 7, the frequency is 12. For this type of situation, how do we calculate the standard deviation? As I already told you, standard deviation, the other name is root mean square deviation. So let's follow the steps. There are the values of x I have written. The next column is all the f. So how do we calculate the frequency? How do we calculate the mean for this type of series? We will know that the that x value x bar is equals to x bar is equals to summation of fx divided by summation of f. Therefore, I am calculating the fx. The next column is fx. 3 into 3, 9. 4 into 9, 36. Similar way, I have calculated all the values of fx. And I have calculated the summation of fx. I need summation of fx, which is 360, divided by summation of f. So I have added all the frequency and I am getting the total value, which is capital N or summation of F, and it is coming as 60. So 360 by 60, which is coming as 6. This is the mean value. Now once I get the mean value, I have to calculate the value of deviations. So I have made the column D. D is equals to X minus X bar. Each value x, so 3 is value 3 minus of x bar is 6, so 3 minus 6 is minus 3. Similarly, 4 minus 6 is minus 2, 5 minus 6 is minus 1. Following the same procedure, I've calculated all the values of d, or for example, I can say, and this value will be d square. So I'll calculate the value of d square. Now I'm squaring up. So 3 3s are 9, 2 2s are 4. And I have calculated all the values of that. And then I will multiply with the frequency. So 3 into 9, 27. 9 into 4, 36. 11 into 1, 11. And I have calculated all the value and added up. And the value is coming as 150. Therefore, what is the formula of sigma? Sigma is equals to square root of summation of FD square divided by capital N. So let's just see what is the value. F into D square. In our case, the value has come as 150 divided by the value of 60. And therefore, I have taken the square root of that and the value has come as 1.571. So this is the way we have to calculate the standard deviation for a ungrouped frequency distribution. Okay, now we will move to the next thing, which is grouped frequency distribution, and how do we find the standard deviation. For a group frequency distribution where the class interval are given, we have taken another example where the values of x are nothing but the CI class interval or class boundary 10 to 20, 20 to 30, 30 to 40, 40 to 50, and all the values, all the class interval, the frequencies are given. For this type of question, the first thing we need to find the mean, and you already know that how to calculate mean, we have to find the mid value of each class interval. So what is the mid value of the class interval, which I have denoted here by capital M? Mid value is 10 plus 20 divided by 2, which is 10 plus 20 divided by 2, which is 15. So I have taken mid value 15, next one is 25, 35, 45, 55, 65. Then we will multiply FM, because you know the x bar or mean is equals to summation of fm divided by summation of f. Therefore, I have calculated the value of each and every fm multiplied each one 25 into 400, 35 into 44, 490, and then we have to find out the total value is coming as 1140. 1140 divided by the total frequency 30, and we have got the value of mean as 38. Now, quite similar to the previous method, we have to find the next step. Next column is B. B is equals to x minus x bar. Here, rather than x, we are taking the mid value, which is m minus x bar. So let's just see 15 minus of 38 minus 23, 25 minus 38, it will come as minus 13, 35 minus 38 minus 3. Following the same method, I've calculated for all these values. And then we have to square it up. So we have squared it up, 23 into 23 square is 529. Definitely it will be a positive value, and then multiplied another column, which is f into d square. So frequency is 1, d square is 529, therefore it will come 529. 4 into 169, 676. Following the same method, we have added all of that, and the value is coming as 3030. Therefore, sigma is equals to 3030. Divided by the total number of frequency, total frequency, which is 30, and I have taken the square root and it's coming as 10.05. In my subsequent video, I'll discuss about how to calculate the standard deviation for a group frequency distribution where the value of mean is coming in decimal. Because if the value of mean is coming at decimal, you will know that this value of d will come also in decimal, and the square it up, it will be very big number and a lot. So it will be a cumbersome job. To avoid that, we use something called assumed mean method. So in my subsequent video, I'll be discussing about the assumed mean method. That's all. Thank you. Thank you.